Autonomous Rail Rapid Transit or ART is a guided bus that autonomously driven with or without driver on board. Despite its name, it is not on the rail, it is on the road. Unlike other videos which took at least 2 weeks to make, this video is hastily edited in less than 3 hours, thus it's short to video duration. What is the story behind the development of ART and how it tried to get its real-world operation in Malaysia since the year 2019? Let's take a ride in ART on a rare opportunity and consider whether ART is a viable option as a transit solution in Malaysian cities. ART use technology where a guided system using either optic guide or GPS is fitted on a bus. The first known guided articulated bus in operation is Transport S-West Rouennais, operated in Rouen, France. Operating since the year 2001, the articulated buses are guided by two lines on the middle of the road. Did you see the broken lines on the road? Yeah, that are the lines that the guided system rely on to ensure that the bus stay on its lane. China has adopted the technology and designed longer bus or rubber tire tram, whatever you call it. The ART that was brought for testing in Malaysia was built by CRRC Zhuzhou Institute. Before someone is allowed to ride the ART, here there is an online form need to be filled on the spot and declare yourself that you are responsible for any accident, injury or death while on the ride. Even with a warning, the ride is full. Therefore, why do we need an ART when the rail transit lines, the other one, are working just fine? Klang Valley has been served by LRT and MRT lines with commuter and KLIA transit into the mix. However, not all places are suitable for the rail transit lines as its construction cost is expensive. Monorail was once poised as the solution for the medium capacity transit as it is cheaper to build and the monorail train is cheaper to buy, albeit its lower capacity. Putrajaya should have monorail operated since 2006 with the bridge and tunnels built, but somehow the project stalled and never finished since. I talked about the Putrajaya monorail in the previous video where this monorail line is the only transit project that was shelved when it was under construction, never finished. The link for this video if you want to watch more is in here. Eventually, traffic in Putrajaya is worsening and there is a pressing need of a transit solution. Therefore, there is a need of a solution that is cheaper than rail transit but cost effective to build and operate. In 2019, the ART sets arrived in Johor Bahru and used on a trial run in Iskandar Puteri for 3 months. Later, ART has been chosen as the vehicle of choice to build BRT system in Johor Bahru, officially named as Iskandar Rapid Transit or IRT. Meanwhile, Kuching Metro developed an interest to adapt hydrogen-powered ART as its transit system against the other rail transit types. ART is attractive due to its higher capacity than city bus, lower construction and operation cost than the rail transit, and suitable for low-density cities that do not justify the need of expensive high-capacity LRT or MRT line. Question is ART a viable option as a reliable transit vehicle? In China, ART has been operating in 3 different cities, a full fare service operation. In the city of Zhuzhou, Hunan, where ART set was built, a short 3 km ART line has been operated since the year 2018. Yipin ART operated in Yipin, Sichuan since 2019, serving the population of more than 2 million people in its metropolitan area. Linggang DRT is the ART line in Linggang, Putong, Shanghai, operating since the year 2021. All of the operating ART lines are in China, thus CRRC Zhuzhou eyeing the export market for its LRT bus, particularly Malaysia. How about the ride in the ART itself? The ride inside is smooth and the width is similar with the city bus. Flat floor permits the disabled to use ART, a great advantage. However, the panel still shows its trial route when this ART set was used for IRT trial run in Horizon Hills in Iskandar Putri. It is a good move that the public could experience the ride in the ART, as it might increase the public interest as a solution to overcome the increasing congested roads of Putrajaya. Furthermore, the possibility of the rejuvenation of the monorail project is slim, since the supplier of the monorail trains, Commirail, has been out of business since the year 2019. Do you think ART is suitable as the replacement for long postponed monorail in Putrajaya? You can comment down below. If you want to ride this ART, the public trial is held in conjunction with Putrajaya Open Day, celebrating the anniversary of the Federal Territory. Otherwise, ART is only operating for testing purposes and only be accessible on special occasions or by invitation. If you are in or nearby Putrajaya, quick! ART Joyride is run until Sunday, 4 February 2024. Thank you so much for watching. I hope we learned something new about ART and whether it is a viable option to replace monorail as the main transit backbone of Putrajaya. Thank you so much for watching again, and see you in the next video.